in general, in every month, we are used to organize such kind of Paisa session throughout the year. Not in the, we started in the pandemic situation. We started from our inception. So today is the second day, and yesterday we have completed our first lecture on Mendeley by Dr. Shavad Nausin successfully. And today is the second session, and it is very proud to announce that today's speaker is our formerly assistant librarian, Dr. Sujit Kujur. Now he is at the deputy librarian of the Sikkim Central University. So before going to deliberation of his today's speech on EdNote, may I request Dr. Nimai Chand Saha, university librarian, for introductory lecture. Nimai, da, please.
Okay, so thank you, Kaushik. At the very outset, let me extend my warm regards and gratitude, of course, congratulations, welcome to all of the participants, ranging from faculty members to research scholars in and out Vishwabharati. And as Dr. Ghosh rightly noted, that today our speaker is beloved Dr. Sujit Ghosh, Sujit Kujur. Yeah, Sujit Kujur, who was my colleague till 21 February 2021, just last month, February 21. And today it is 30th of March, just 1 month, 8 days. He has left us, and the sticker was ex-colleague of Vishwabharati, Dr. Sujit Kujur, now, who is in his excellency, in his capacity to hold the chair of deputy librarian of another Indian prestigious central university, none other than Sikkim Central University. So he is there, and right today until 20th April, he is now acting there as librarian. So by chair, he and me, there is no one. Yeah, deputy librarian, but now you are acting there as librarian in charge till 20th February. So by position till this day, by designation, by position. So I welcome you, Dr. Kujur, as my beloved brother and my affectionate colleagues earlier. And of course, today I don't found that you are far away from me, but I consider you as a member of Vishwabharati Library Network, and we will go together jointly in our hands. And who is supposed to be joined there as librarian, Dr. Sriram, who is also very good relation with me. So with your good cooperation as your deputy librarian and Dr. Sriram as librarian, I think these two are the neighbor and nearest central university. So we'll go together. How can we showcase our library services to address our scholars and academics needs? So with this spirit, I actually asked Dr. Kujur when he was in this campus just March 12 to 16, like that. One day he came with me and I asked him, Dr. Kujur, you have to deliver one lecture and I am giving you a small invitation. So he's point blank agreed with me in spite of his schedule as librarian, as deputy librarian in multifarious position he has now hold, and the university is very new to him. Still, he is very confident enough on the topic concerned, since he has delivered many lectures on EndNote. He has mastery on that software. So he has agreed that, and as Nimaida told, I'll deliver lecture there. And you see, today Dr. Kujur will highlight the EndNote. So many of the academics, ranging of faculty members to scholars, they thought that EndNote means footnote and EndNote. Basically, we learned EndNote means along with footnote, footnote and EndNote. Footnote and EndNote, as you know, something we need to give at the foot of the particular page where we are giving an idea which is not giving a full explanation of that particular idea. To exemplify, to define, to support. And the EndNote will be at the end of the very chapter. So that's the thing. But the basic connotation, basic philology of EndNote and footnote is same. But today, Dr. Kujur is going to highlight and to demonstrate the EndNote as software. Software means it's actually reference management software. Yesterday, as you listen from Dr. Sabhat and this Mendeley, is that Mendeley is full free to, but EndNote is not full free like Mendeley is. Mendeley actually EndNote is part free, it's free.
So, Sujit,
yes.
Due to the technical error of Nimaida, Nimaida told me to proceed for you. So, may I request our today's speaker, Dr. Sujit Kujur, Deputy Librarian, Sikkim Central University. Sujit, please, you may proceed.
Okay. Thank you, Kaushik and Nimaida, for the brief introduction. Yes, as Nimaida told that I was in Vishwabharti attached with you all. And I'm not so far, I'm not feeling that I'm detached with Vishwabharati. Whether it is very proud to be a member of Vishwabharati, and today I'm very privileged that Nimaida invited me for giving that lecture, which I usually give in Vishwabharati to you all. So, EndNote, we are going to take today, as Nimaida briefly mentioned, that Mendeley EndNote is the tools which we where we manage our citation while we writing anything. So just please wait, I just share my screen. So I think my screen is visible to all.
Yes, it is visible. You may proceed.
Thank you, Kaushik, for confirming. So, earlier, EndNote was started long back, and now it is attached with Clarivate. So, as the topic, you can see EndNote Citation Manager. This citation issue is very important for research writing. And all the papers, theses, books, writing, and all the things we require citations, because citation is where you tell your readers that certain material in your work come from another source. It also gives your readers the information necessary to find that source again. That includes information about the author, title of the work, the name of the location or company that publishes your copy of the resource, the date your copy was published, the page number of the material you are borrowing. This information are very important while giving citation to other, because it will safeguard for your writing, your work, your creation. So in future, it will become your own document by giving reference citation to others. And next slide will be why cite sources, why it is so important to give citation. Very simple thing is that when we take material from anything, because we don't have all the complete idea by our own self, we get many things by reading different sources. So it is very essential to give weightage to the author who created or who give the idea earlier. So giving credit to the original author by citing source is the only way to use other people's work without plagiarizing. So it will save you from the plagiarizing. And it will be very helpful to keep your writing effectively. The citation are extremely helpful to anyone who wants to find out more about your ideas and where they come from. So these are the few points you are seeing in the slide. Citing source shows the amount of research you have done. Citing source strengthen your work by lending outside support to your work. See, these things I have taken from this website, plagiarism.org. So this is the in the same way as I given the source, you have to give citation in your writings. So there are various types of writing styles available throughout the globe. APA, MLA, Chicago, Tarbian, IEEE for technical writings. And there are various numbers of writing styles available throughout the globe for writing different kinds of paper. Like scientific paper, we use generally for technical writing, we use generally IEEE format, Chicago and MLA are the traditional for the social science work. So different types of, from mathematics, there are different styles. So we come to know in the practical session when we show you different types of the various kinds of this citation styles are available. So what reference management tools do? It capture your resource as you find them on the internet. It help you to organize and save your sources. Insert citation in your written work. Create a bibliography. So there are enormous number of reference management tools are available, as you show in the figure, Mendeley, Zotero, InNote, then RefWork, Reference Manager. Even in the simple Word, we have one reference icon in the ribbon. So from there also, you can manage your references. So in the last class, I think in the last session, in the Mendeley, you can have some idea about the reference management and how it will work. So today we are taking InNote. InNote is a software package that allow you to collect and manage citation from, generate formatted bibliographies in the range of styles, including classic styles like Harvard and Vancouver, two different kinds of styles. As you saw earlier, there are so many writing styles. And university institute have access of ESS. Those are institute having ESS resource. I mean, from IFLIPnet, we are getting e-resources like Vishwabharati are provided with the free access to InNote. It can be downloaded to your computer. So thing is that those institute or university having funded by UGC and getting e-resources through IFLIPnet, they are getting Web of Science database. And in the Web of Science database, there is a tag attached application is there, InNote. So those are having Web of Science, they are getting InNote online free of cost for the institutional members only. So there are two versions, two modes of InNote. There are desktop version and online version. And desktop version is that it create, store, manage reference citations. It insert reference citation from InNote desktop library into Microsoft Word document and automatically creates a bibliography. It means that the desktop version means it will be downloaded into the single desktop. And from that desktop only, you can store, you can manage your reference and you can do your work easily. And the online version is that it is an online service that allow you to store, share, and organize your citations so that you can access them from any computer. By installing the Microsoft Word plugin, you can cite reference from your library and automatically create your bibliographies as you write. The difference between desktop and online is that in online, you have to create one account. like ID and password, like email ID and password, and you can create generally for the login anything. Same way, you have to create one ID, and in by logging in that ID and password, you can have your InNode database to any computer, which desktop doesn't have. Doesn't desktop means you have to devote one particular computer, and on that you can do that InNode function. But online, by plugging Microsoft Word, you can able to access your whole data in any machine. That means you no need to carry your desktop anywhere, desktop or laptop anywhere. You can go anywhere. You can plug in this Microsoft Word, and your whole InNode database is with you at the right moment with the internet connectivity. So why InNode we use? It creates a customized library of all your references. It inserts those references in Microsoft Word, OneForm, Mathematica 8, Apple, Page. InNode will automatically create citation and bibliography matching the requirements of your selected journal or style manual. It has over 6,000 bibliographic styles from which you to choose. As I show you 2-3 earlier, like MLA, APA, Vancouver, Chicago, and all these things I show you, there are more than 6,000 bibliographic styles available. It attaches PDF, sounds, video, or any other kind of files for your reference. It means you can view any video in YouTube or any other video channels. From there, you can make the citation styles. Any type of file, any sound, MP3, videos, PDF, Word, or internet document, any kind of document you have, you can make that references. Because everything have different kind of styles to write. Like for the book, basic books, textbook, and other book, reference book, you have to write different kind of styles to create a citation. It organizes your library using group to categorize reference by project, subject, or anything else you choose. The same reference can be as many group as you want. You can organize your library. Even you can share your bibliography to other people. Like you are suppose that you are a guide and you are taking research scholars under you. You already make one subject, and your scholars are doing research on the same similar kind of topic. So you can share your bibliography to them, so that he no need to again search the same bibliography again. From your bibliography, he can follow the different materials available, and what are the study you have already done, and he can carry on the study beyond that searches. So it can synchronize your InNode reference and group across multiple computers, share reference with others, and access your reference from almost anywhere with any internet browser. As I already told you that with the login ID and password, you can able to do your InNode work, means referencing work, anywhere, anytime. So there is a login. Direct login for InNode is my innodeweb.com. Or if you have a Web of Science, so you can log in to the Web of Science, and there is an option to log in InNode. You just click on that and you can be directly log in with the same ID and password. So there is a option to create your login ID in InNode. So first you have to go Web of Science page with this available link. If you have Web of Science user, sign in to the Web of Science and click on the InNode link to open your InNode library. If you don't have a InNode ID earlier, so you can create easily by logging into the myinnode.web.com. So this kind of page will appear to you. So here you can register yourself by putting very basic information like your name, email ID, and you create your password. And after that, you can have two other options to log in, like if you have Facebook or LinkedIn ID. So through that ID also, you can directly log in to your EndNote. So after logging in, you get getting started guidelines, means how you start your EndNote, how you carry your EndNote, that will appear directly. So after installing, you can have to install two plugins, two important plugins. First is to go to the download option. There you can find site while you write, whatever you have operating system in your machine. Maybe you have Apple, so download Macintosh. If you have download as MSI version, so you can accordingly, you can choose with three basic installation. This installation help you to plug in your Word. While you're writing anything on Word, it will be plug in there. I will show you in the practical so it will be more clear. And second is capture reference. Capture reference is nothing, you just click the capture button and just drag it to your bookmark menu. So it will be directly plug in there. So these two important plugins are there. Their uses are different. I will show you in the practical session. And there is a new update came in the EndNote. Is click EndNote click here. You can save time getting PDF into EndNote with the free browser plugin. Here again, you have to install one plugin. So there are three kinds of way you can collect references in your databases. Online, new reference. New reference means manually you have to import reference. Suppose that you have any information regarding your data, or you have a PDF but you don't have the bibliographic information. So you can choose the different libraries. Like Library of Congress, you can select from there, you can fetch the data and make the bibliographic, complete bibliography. So here I show you 1, 2, and 3 window. First one showing online search. Here you can choose different libraries by selecting favorite, and you can install the data directly from that library. New references means you have to put manually. Suppose that you have something, some document where directly PDF from different sources, but you don't have the exact source. So you have to find the source and put bibliography manually. And third is to import bibliography from different sources. Suppose that you have one PDF in your desktop and you want to make their database into your EndNote database. So you have to select, choose the file from the desktop, wherever it is kept, and select the import button from different libraries and import. So all the bibliographic data will be fetched and saved into your database. So these three are the main source from where you can select data or collect data or make the database of bibliography. And as I show you, like in my bookmark menu, there is a capture references there. When you click, this new window will appear, and whatever the page is open, it will capture the whole bibliographic data automatically. You no need to write here. You can write by yourself whatever you find. The incomplete data is there. You can fill up by yourself and save it to my EndNote. So it will save into the online version, EndNote online version. And this EndNote shows the desktop version. So these two are the options available. So you can share, organize your library and create groups. By default, EndNote place reference into the on field folder, you can create up to 50,000 groups to organize your preferences. In whatever way best supports your work habit. Here you just go to the organize, manage group, then the available group, whatever I created, it's showing here. You can create by clicking new group and you can give the folder name and all the document will be saved into that folder. Like here I created Ambedkar education, extra games and sports, librarianship, library science, library marketing, new group, research. So how many numbers are in that folder is showing here, 2-3 number of document I have shared. And by clicking the share option, I can able to share with anyone. I will show you in the practical session, so it will be more clear to you. So site value right is the main thing what we are going to use in our writing styles. While we writing any paper or thesis, article, anything, or book chapter, book, anything we are going to write, we usually use Word document. So there is a, you can see InNote plugin was there, and you can see insert citation, go InNote online, then style and update, you can create bibliography and all these things. First thing is that you have to find and select citations and insert them into your manuscript. Reformat your entire paper and bibliography with one click. Choose from thousands of available styles. Edit citations to add information such as page number or group multiple reference in one citation. So like here, API style is selected. If you choose another style, so automatically by clicking that one, entire document, all the reference styles, citation style will be changed automatically. This is the another great feature of InNote. Match your manuscript to the best right journal. If you want to publish your paper in one reputed journal, which is under JRC data or Web of Science database, that kind of standard journal, you want to publish your manuscript. So you just put the title, your abstract, and references, and the InNote search the best journal where to publish. It will give the best match to publish your research paper. So this is about the theoretical part of InNote. Now I want to take you in the live demo, so it will be more easier and more understandable by InNote. Let me open the web page. So when you put the address www.myinnoteweb.com, it will be redirect to the accessclarivate.com login page. This is the InNote landing page, as I show you in the figure. If you have ID, so you can directly log in. If you don't have, then you just click on register. By clicking this, the basic information they require: your email address, your password, you retype your password, your first name, last name, then this captcha, and click on the register, that much only. So by clicking this, you can register yourself. Or if you don't want to put all these things, you just click, if you have Facebook ID or or LinkedIn, you just click here. With this ID, you also get login. So here you can see the try InNode desktop for 30 days. We think you will like it. So this is the desktop version. If you click, it will give you 30 days trial version. And after that, they will want some charges to continue. So as the institute like Vishwabharti, you are getting InNode online free of cost. So you can, I suggest you just go to the InNode online version. So I already have the login ID and password. I just going to log in. So though I already have my login ID and password, that's why it will come to my reference. Otherwise, it will, when you first time login, it will give you this kind of view, like getting started, then store and set and create. So while reaching here, you just go to the download, click on download. There you can find site value right, capture reference, InNode, click. So first you have to download site value right plugin. So most of us, we are using Microsoft Word. So you just click on the first option, download Windows. When you click, the automatically plugin will start downloading at the bottom of your web page. See, downloading is very simple. When it is downloaded, you just click on run. When you click the run, you know, the system will automatically find what is the basic requirement of the installing file need. It will check by itself and automatically it will be downloaded to your computer. It will take two to five minutes to download in your system. I already downloaded, so I'm not going to install again. And after that, you have to install this capture reference. Capture reference is very simple. You just click, right click here and drag it to your this address bar, not address bar, your favorite bar. So it will be directly saved to your, directly saved in your capture references. I will show you the utility of that capture reference. And this InNode click, it will, if you click here, it will redirect to you another web page here. It will give you anything, the PDF document available in the website. They will try to give you the original PDF. So we are not going on that. So after that, you just go on the collection page. There you can manage your collections. So there are the three options: online search, new reference, import reference. In online reference, as I show you that I have selected this much of library where I can directly import the bibliography from different libraries. So by default, I click on Library of Congress. If you want to choose other libraries, so just click on favorite. Then here you can find many libraries throughout the globe. So whatever thing you want to add in your favorite, you just suppose that Trinity Christian Dublin library I want to add in my database where I want to paste the data. So you just copy on the copy to favorite. So it will be save to you, save directly into your favorite. So whenever next time you select here, see, it is here. If you want to collect, now here you want to search your keyword, from which data you want to fetch the data. So from there, you can directly save the data from different libraries. Second option is new reference. Here, suppose that you want to add something manually. This gives you to enter manually data. Reference type you have to choose. There are different types of styles like generic, ancient, insert text, artwork, bills, blog, books, book section, case, catalog, conference proceedings, dictionary, edited book. See, so many things are there. This is unpublished work, television episode, social media, serial report, postcard, patent, anything, whatever you want to add as a reference type, you just click. Suppose I click on the patent, so the bibliographic types, the options are changing. If I am to use encyclopedia, so it will be, the fields are automatically converting by itself. So you just click the reference types and put the author name, title, the information you have, you just put it here. And at the, if you want to save in different groups, I haven't put anything, so it will not give me the option to save, otherwise it will become saved. Suppose that I choose this one, Kujur Sujit. So now this save button is activated. So in this way, you can create your bibliography manually. And there is an option to import references from different sources. Suppose that I want to make anything. Suppose that I want to make this bibliography of that document available in my desktop. So I have to select different all database. Then from which folder I want to save that one. And I want to import. If data is available, so it will automatically fetch the data. Now, there is an option of organize. Like I have created many folders is there, many groups I've created. You can, if you want to create new group, any group, you just click here, give the name. InNode. If I want to create one group as InNode, just click here. See, the InNode is created. Now the document is zero. Suppose that this InNode I want to share with anyone, my colleague or any research community. You just, sorry, I have not selected that one. I have to select, then I have to share. For sharing, I have to put the email from which I want to share. I have to give one email. So it will be directly shared with that particular person. So you have to choose the privilege, what privilege you want to share. To read only, read and write only. Read and write means he can make some edit also. If you want to give that privilege, so you can put on the read and write, so it will say share accordingly. I don't have any other groups, so there is nothing to share. If you suppose that while doing your research for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years work, you read many documents time to time and you saved once, twice, thrice times. So you can check it here. You can click on the find duplicate. So whatever the document duplicate saved here, it will become and listed here. You just omit whatever you don't want and save only single document. You can manage the attachment. If you, while creating any document, you sometime attach some documents like PDF, some videos directly with your database. So those things also available here with the available space of 2 GB. So formatting, suppose that first time you want to write something, so you have to suppose that any document you are working, suppose that on Ambedkar I have worked, now my work is complete. Suppose that I am working on thesis and I create the folder Ambedkar. Now after completing my entire work, I have to create one bibliography. So I choose Ambedkar, then bibliographic style. Whatever style I have chosen, I have to suppose that MLA 5th version I want to choose. And there is a different three types of formats: HTML, text, RTF. In three format I want to in any one format I want to save, I want to just click on text. Then if I want to save directly the entire document on that Ambedkar folder contain the different document, it will be saved accordingly. Or if I want to see the preview of that particular document, so on that particular, there are only two documents, so it will be entire bibliography is complete here. So from here, copying and pasting in the main text also possible. Same way, site while you write, if you not plug in that time, from here also there is option to directly plug in here. Now you want to format your paper, you choose your file in RTF format, then bibliographic style you have to choose. See here, only few styles are available, and I told you that there are 6,000 bibliographic styles are there. So I will show you where, from where you can select. So see, there is an option to select favorite. See, this is in the favorite. Here I can make only 25 writing styles at a time. But in the masterly, there are more than 6,000 writing styles available. Okay. So here you can suppose that Abacus, I want to add in my favorite. You just click Abacus, then add to my favorite. Now Abacus is available. So if I want to add Abacus format, so it is available. Whatever choose here, the same thing will be available in your Word format. While you writing in the Word format, the same styles are available to choose. If you want to export your entire reference style to any other platform, suppose that from Mendeley, so InNode to Mendeley, you want to export your data, you just do from here also. You just click, see these are the 3-4 formats available. You just click whatever suits in the switching management software, citation management software. So you can choose accordingly and you can save and just import in that particular database. So it will be switched to that particular, suppose that in order to you want to choose Zotero. So you just make the export file, you just import that files in the Zotero. It will be all the entire document available in the InNode. You go to switch to your Zotero. So here I show you matching option. See, if you have any manuscript and you want to publish somewhere else, you are looking for the best journal you want to publish, you can do it here. So by clicking match manuscript, you have so I already have that ID and password of, so here you put the title and the abstract, and by clicking find the journal, it will try to find throughout the globe which is the best journal where your manuscript should going to be published. They will suggest you the list of the journal where you want to where you can publish your paper. So this is the new feature and very advanced feature. Many times we are very confused where to publish, so it will help you in that way. Now I show you from how you can save different documents from different places, like we see different sources from different journals in even Google Scholar also. So from there also we can suppose that from Google Scholar you want to add something in your database, so you can do it. Suppose that I want to search agriculture. Suppose that I want to search something agriculture production, and this article is required to say into my database. I want to add into my database. So here is I will show you in two formats. Suppose that this is the article you want to add. See, this is asking for the access. I don't have access, but I need the bibliography of this one. You just simply capture reference. You have to give ID and password. I think if you log in from Vishwabharati, it will not ask every time this login ID and password, because my ID is created from Vishwabharati. So that's why I log in from IP range of Sikkim University. That's why it is asking. Otherwise, it is not asking this ID and password. I think that's why it is not fetching also data. Otherwise, it will fetch the data directly. Like author, it will take directly, fetch the data. Title and all the basic information, it will take directly by itself. You don't need to do anything. Though I am accessing from Shanti, Sikkim University, and my ID is from Vishwabharati, that's why it is not permitting me to take, fetch the data. Another way, from Google Scholar, you can do it. You just simply create one. You just from Google Scholar, you just go to your left hand corner where Google Scholar is written with three lines. You just make a setting. See, bibliographic manager is there. you just click here in note and save. So now what happened? See that import to InNote is came. So if you want to add this one into your InNote, you just click directly import to InNote. So it will save to your InNote database, this agriculture development by Benzmeyer, D. Benzmeyer and Hardy. So from Google Scholar, you can save that entire document from import to InNote option. Suppose that you see YouTube. Suppose that I want to save this video into my database. So you just click on the capture reference. Where there is no option to save directly into InNote, you just click on the capture reference. So whatever in the screen, their bibliographic information will be came directly to. See, abstract is there, content is embedded video, keywords is there, URL is there. No author, it's a title, music. I think this title is music, so automatically this music came. And whatever information available behind this video, all the information come here. So if you want to save whatever InNote, I just created InNote, I want to save in the InNote database. Just click on the save. So this is the reference type and all the information, whatever we captured, automatically save into our InNote database. So same way, suppose that from Shodh Ganga, we want to save some data. So from the Shodh Ganga also, there is a thesis, is a main resource of our research work. So suppose that from this university, I want to add one thesis into my database. So that can also be done here through the option of capture reference. Suppose that this title is important for me. So if I capture here, so see, all the information, it's in this journal title. You just check and click on thesis. So all the things are saved entirely. So this is the beauty of capture reference. It's so easy. On one click, all the entire document in the screen is saved as your bibliographic information. Now, the main thing I just want to show you. See, while you save write cite while you write option, so this InNote will appear in your Word entire Word Outlook, Word menu. Okay, suppose that this is one article I have written. Suppose that this is one article I have written. Now I want to, while writing, I want to put one citation here. So what we do, click on EndNote. When you click on EndNote, one EndNote menu will appear separately in this way. Now you want to insert something, you just click on, see, as I by default selected Abacus Online, so it is by default Abacus. So suppose that I want to insert anything. So here all the reference available to me is saved here. Suppose that I want to add this one as a reference here. I just selected and click on insert. See, all the different citation styles will automatically come here according to the Abacus. If I want to change in MLA, APA 5th edition, I just click here. So automatically it will be changed. See, there are some format is changed. Same way, if I want to change on Chicago, see that comma is omitted and ampersand and become A and D N. So in this way, it will be by clicking all the format styles you will change. And at the bottom, you can see the bibliography automatically arranged. And it will be arranged according to the alphabet. You no need to rearrange the things again. So whatever you do, in, suppose that here again, I want to add some insert. I want to insert something here. Insert citation is there, already inserted at the bottom, bibliography already arranged. You can see earlier only the this ZR started, now G become upward. It will not came down, but it will be arranged according to the alphabet. If I have to change in APA, see the format and all entire things is changed. So in this way, you can manage your reference styles. And suppose that in between, I want to add more than one citation for the same insert, suppose that. See, two references are added for a single paragraph. Maybe two persons idea I put into the same this one paragraph. So I can put two references together, three references together. And if I want to remove one author or two author, or only one citation style should be remain as I want. So that also can be done. You just click on right click, not in the right click. Edit citation. Here, if you want to edit anything, you can do from here. Suppose that this one go upward, you can do upward. Okay. So this will be changed accordingly. From here also you can do. So in this way, you can manage your entire work. So this is about the presentation. And I think it is, I feel it is very short time, and matters are so huge to understand and grasp everything one time. I suggest you just get plug-in, just practice once and twice. And after that, I think you can understand yourself very nicely. Because I also learned by trial and error method. I install, I tried, and sometimes I get some confusion. Then I clarify from different sources, the tutorial available in the InNode website. So many things going to be clear like that. In the same way, if you want to go any other citation management software like Mendeley, Zotero, you can involve yourself first. Then only it can be, you are going to be expert on that, and it will be save your time. See, many time, many question answer, which is the best citation management software, InNode, Zotero, Mendeley, and other. So this is very difficult question, and I just simply answer whatever suits you, you can apply that one. See, InNode is a online version, and Zotero, Mendeley also have the online facilities now. InNode is a commercial, and Zotero and Mendeley in other side, they are the open source. But the beauty is that you can do anything. Means your purpose should be fulfilled. Even if you don't want to do anything, there is an option for refresh in the world also. You just click on that. But here, thing is that you cannot insert directly. You have to input the data. You have to create database by inputting manually. You have to create on the manage, then everything will become. And there is no, there are only the selective writing styles available in the reference available in the world. But this reference management software tools are available where you can manage any kind of writing style, any kind of citations with the clicks. So these are the benefits of InNode and other reference management softwares. So I think this is too much for today. If you have any query or questions, you may ask. So I try to clarify as much I can. Kaushik, I'm done.
Sujita, thank you for the such kind of tremendous demonstration, both the theoretical part through PPT and hands-on training through the online. So may I request all participants, if you have any question, submit your query to directly to the Sujita either or through chat box. So I will answer the question of the Rituparna, which is not related to today's session. So I will come to later, but before, so Nimaita is available today or now?
Kaushik,
if any
I'm available.
Okay. So before going to conclude by the our university librarian, so may I request to the all participants, please ask any question or submit your query through chat box. So Nimaita, please.
Okay. So I think I can take up the wrap-up remarks soon after the interaction part is over. Mm-hmm. So I think now this is the time when participants might directly interact by muting their microphone and interact with Sujita directly. Or if it is any problem, then better to come through chat box, as Kaushikda told. Then this is the time. If you do not have any questions, then one question is already in the chat box. Kaushikda will take care about the answer of that particular question, since it is related to gesture accessibility. It's very oldest and it's very simple and easier questions. I think Rituparna is not very accustomed with the Viswarthi Library Services. That's why this very primary level questions he asked here. Anyway, since he is asking, we will give answer. And then Sujita is waiting. If any question, through chat box or by direct audio mode, you can take a part on that.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes, please.
Yes.
Sir, in terms of reference management software, which do you think is...
Please introduce yourself. Pramita, introduce yourself.
Okay, sir. I'm Pramita Majumdar from Department of Social Work.
Okay. Research scholar.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So, sir, which...
yes. Now
which reference management software is more computer friendly, like in terms of downloading plugins and... other technicalities which might be required, which is more user friendly?
See, as I told you that many softwares are available, including InNote. InNote is a commercial software, but it is free to you in terms of you are the research scholar, or means you are attached with Vishwabharati, so it is available to you. So once you log in InNote, you can go anywhere anytime without your system, but with the internet connectivity, you can sit any machine. You can log in yourself in InNote, and entire database come with you in your system. In the same way, many other open source softwares also working, like Zotero or Mendeley. I told Mendeley yesterday, you have I think attended the session, so you can get an idea about the Mendeley. So Mendeley also providing the same kind of things. Mendeley have their own limits, and Zotero have their own limits. All are different platform, but thing is that your work should be done in the proper way and the minimum time. So I suggest whatever suits you, you can see. I think one or two reference management software we are dealing today is InNote. Yesterday you are already acquainted with Mendeley. So whatever suits you, you can go with that. And technicality means both are working almost the same thing. InNote is some other features also, like you can publish your paper anywhere. That can suggest by the software itself, and that feature is not available in Zotero or Mendeley. And user friendly means all are almost equivalent to each other. All are the same. So it is up to you which you like most.
So, do you advise that we like test run all of the softwares to have a better idea on which would work?
As I told you, there is an option of import and export options available. If you want to start, you can start with InNote also. And after that, you don't feel comfortable with the InNote, you can switch to other open source software also. So with that export button, all your entire database, whatever you saved in your InNote, you can switch to other also. In the same way, you can want to switch from other software to InNote, you can do it easily.
Okay, sir.
There is the option.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. First, you have to try, then only you can judge yourself. Mm-hmm.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Sujita, there is another question in chat box. So from Sonam Jongpo ma'am. So is this EndNote or reference facility is also available and accessible to other language users?
Yes. It will work with any language. All the reference management software are incompatible with all the languages. Even you write Hindi and you want to add this reference style, you just click on that, it will work referencing. Thing is that you have to create database, then only it will work.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes,
please. I'm Shivana Ghosh from Information Department, Research Scholar. My question is, if we connected a login to EndNote to Vishwavati network, then when we will be at home, can we access that?
Yes. when you create your account, you have to use Vishwabharati network. After that, getting your ID and password, you can go anywhere. Just log in with that, your ID and password, and you can able to access your all the database anywhere.
Okay, sir. And another question. Actually, before I already logging in from my home, so can I be able to log in? I already done it before.
Okay.
So in my from my home. So can I do it again from Vishwabharati network now?
No. You have from already ID. You already have ID.
Yeah.
You told that you have two ID. Yes, right? And one is your personally. You have done from anywhere, and another is from Vishwabharati. So whatever you have, the maximum database you have, you use that account.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay.
So there is no such kind of question related to the today's special session. So
thing is that first you have to try involve yourself with this software.
Yes.
Then only question will come.
Sure.
The short 1 hour lecture, it is very difficult to get the question because most of the things are new to the participant. I think there is that's why questions are very less.
Sure. Agreed with you. So I am answering the question related to the gesture by Rituponda. So then I actually gesture, as you know, we are using the gesture and subscribing through the ESS platform. So there are two types of accessibility of the gesture. So there is no such kind of user ID and password. So first you have to access the gesture either through your network. That is, if you are under the MHRD connection, then it is accessible, or from your drawing room, it is accessible through the open access, through the remote access. So from this is for your kind information that the existing remote access by EBSCO named Open Athens, it is available up to 31st March 2021. So from 1st April onwards, we are introducing the LS Discovery, where Discovery service and remote access both will be available through LS Discovery. And tomorrow our special session on LS Discovery. So you are all welcome. And my humble request to you all, please come and join and share the news for tomorrow's session. And may I request our university librarian, Dr. Nimaichand Saha, for concluding remarks on today's session. Nimaita, please.
Okay, thank you. So at the very end, and before to extend my sincere thanks, Dr. Khujur, I would like to pay my sincere thanks to all the participants. And as you know, every time, as I told that the number is not the issue to the Vishwabharati Library Network, as I have been received many requests from my scholars and faculty members that Nimaida, we need to have this kind of special program frequently. So as a part of that request, we are conducting these sessions every now and then, most likely 2-3 months, every after 2-3 months, we are organizing this kind of event. But the number is very discouraging to me in the platform. It is around 31, 33, like that. And as Dr. Sujit Khujur is now chairing as deputy librarian at Sikkim Central University, he has valued in his time. Still, since immediately he has left us without our, request, he was not in a position to escape, to deny me. That's why he is taking my acceptance and proposal and accepting our invitation and giving his time and expertise. So I request all the around 30 participants to use this software as much as you can. And if any problem, though Sujitda is there, without taking his permission, I am giving you on behalf of Dr. Sujitda to blank check. If you face any trouble, any problem, don't hesitate. You just drop a question through mail to Sujitda, and he will be kind enough to answer your questions, because he is a man who is always trying to excel the quality of the academic activities, particularly for publication and writing activities like that. So don't worry about that. And I think today's session, like yesterday's, he has taken up the PowerPoint presentation as well as online demonstration to express how EndNote is working in online version, in online mode, and how he's helping scholars to have their research and publication activity. If members, if any scholars intend to learn this EndNote Zotero. So knowledge, either Mendeley or Zotero or this EndNote, which you think suitable or user-friendly from your level, you can take it up and you can download, and your research thesis submission will be 3 months earlier. And if you have target that throughout my academic career, I will publish 80 publications, it will be 100 publications, no issue, because time will be much for quality write-up in terms of you know, research activities, I mean, thesis, dissertations, and at the same time, your, you know, some sort of paper writings, you all are welcome to browse and take access of our Grammarly account. And every scholars, those who are having email ID, they are right away access our and take account of our Grammarly account. Notice have been already uploaded, and Kaushik also sent through mail and WhatsApp. And at the same time, those who do not have the Vishwadi domain mail ID through their Gmail, Rocket Mail, Hotmail, or Yahoo Mail, if they intend to access Grammarly, they just drop a mail to me, and I will take care for the activation of Grammarly accessibility. And within the Grammarly, you may have the scope to check the English writing language and other things. And at the same time, there is a plagiarism software where you can have a primary ID that what is my writing status, how it is showing like that. And finally, before publication, before submitting of your publication, before submitting of your thesis, without any word, you are accountable to check your thesis and write up through Urkund, but not a file many times, because it has a severe like that. So that can be exceeded, that cannot be taken up. So please, if any check is removed through Grammarly, is a software, you can check it up for knowledge. And there are also many open source plagiarism software. And finally, come to all are right to denoted as research tools, this reference management tools, this plagiarism tools, tools on language laboratory, speech laboratory, technology laboratory. All together for the proper and simpler way of activities. So without much time, let me participants, scholars, and all the academics who are on the floor, we have all of to Sikkim University General and the Deputy Administrator, Dr. Sudhir Pujur, my brother and ex-colleague, in particular for your kind and very expertise presentation to enlighten our scholars and faculty members. We'll beg from you same kind of cooperation. And I think without thinking twice, like this time, you will accept Sujit and Nimai and Kaushik that we are fragmented. We all are now agglomerated, amalgamated, and all we run towards better library services, better research is like that. And finally, let me just extend my deep Dr. Kaushik Ghosh, who is taking the participants from my side. Let me just conclude and hand over to Dr. Ghosh for finals to wrap up the session. Thank you, Kaushik, please.
Okay. Thank you, Nimaida. So in a word, I can say thank you all. But at last but not least, I congratulate and thank you to our today's speaker, Dr. Sujit Kujur, Deputy Librarian, Sikkim Central University, who was our earlier colleague. So thank you for your such kind of great tremendous presentation, both the theoretical part through PPT as well as the hands-on training through the online demo. So thank you once again to the speaker, and thank you
for
all the participants, and thank you to all the members of the Vishwa Bharati Library Network.
Thank you very much. I will share the PPT. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So
okay, thank you, Kaushik. Then we can leave the meeting.
Okay. Thank you, Nimaita. 1 second.
Thank you, Sujit.
Thank you, Nimaita.
Okay. Bye. Bye. See you again.